Hi guys, welcome to That College Page. This is Samriddhi. Today we're going to be talking about everything that you need to know if you want to apply or get a SIM card in Canada. So we'll be talking about the service providers, the documents that you would require once you go to buy a plan or to get a SIM card, the plans that includes the student plans and the discounts, and things you need to look for in a plan. So let's get started. The first things first, you can either get your own phone from India or you can go buy one from Canada. So what generally people do is that they take their Indian phone, and if you have bought the Indian phone, it will be unlocked, but you should always check it once in India that if the phone is unlocked, so that you don't have any problems once you go there, but just to be on the safe side. But if you've gotten it and you've bought it, they generally give an unlocked phone, so you just have to go and buy a SIM card there and you do not have to get a new phone. But if you have to get a new phone, you can have either you can buy it on a down payment. You can just go to any of the stores and you can down, like you can go to Best Buy or you can go to the Apple store, or you can go and get it on a plan. So let me explain the entire process to you as to how you're supposed to go get your phone on contract. So there are two ways where how you can get a SIM card. One, it's a prepaid plan, and the other is a postpaid plan. So let me explain the prepaid plan first. It's very basic, it's self-explanatory. You pay exactly how much you use. Maybe like if you've used a particular amount, you just have to pay what you've used. I personally think that it is more expensive because it charges you approximately 40 to 45 cents per minute of calling and text messages. Like 40 cents for calling per minute and 40 cents per text message. 40 to 45 depends from the company, and it varies from company to company. It's not a fixed cost, but it's approximately in this range. So it ends up becoming more than what you actually bargained for, because if you get a plan, you end up with a lot of offers and services. So that being said, you do not have to take any of these documents when you go to get a prepaid plan. It's just a card. You can go to any of these convenience stores and you can go and you can tell them that you need a basic telephone SIM card, just a number, and they'll give you these cards with different amount of balance in that. You just have to pay. You can get it with a simple ID as well. So that is everything that you need to know for the prepaid card. But as someone who's been living there, I would always suggest that you do not take the prepaid card if you're living there as a student or you're living there for a period of time that's longer than a few weeks, because that will not be helpful. You will end up paying more than what you bargain for. Now let's get to the postpaid plan. That you need to for this, you need to decide what services do you need. So it consists of three services: calling, texting and data. So mostly people go for a monthly plan. That if you're taking a monthly plan and you want to change your phone, you can take a phone on contract from the service provider that you're getting. You have to pay a nominal, I would give this disclaimer that the telecom services in Canada are extremely expensive. My Jio users in India will know how it feels, because we have been using internet and high speed, good quality internet, mind you, for really good, like really economical prices. And when you go there and you have to pay like $40, $50, $60 every month just for your telephone service, it feels like, but you gotta do what you gotta do. So yeah, this is a monthly service, and maybe you pay like $5, $10, $20 depending on the cell phone that you're buying, and you end up with a new phone after 2 years. So how the contract rolls, you're supposed to take this phone and you get a brand new packed phone with that contract, and you have to make sure that you keep that same plan for the next 2 years. And after you've used that plan for 2 years, you can keep the phone, you can sell it off, you can do whatever you want to with that phone, but for 2 years you have to keep that same contract. And every month you pay a little extra than what you used to for the phone. But it is somehow for someone like students who do not have a large amount of money, lump sum money kept aside just for these expensive appliances, you can get it. It's sort of an EMI, but it spans for a longer period of time, and you end up buying the phone for comparatively less for what it is in the market. But you, if you feel like, you know, my plan is not good enough and I don't feel like the service of this service provider is good enough and I'm not getting the network everywhere, you cannot change it midway. You have to make sure that you carry it for 2 years. Otherwise, you have to return the phone and then... So yeah, the documents that you would need once you go and you need to apply for a SIM card. So the documents would be your SIN number. So for the SIN number is the social security number that you get once you go to Canada. I think you have to go get it done from the Service Ontario office. You have to get it made and it's extremely easy. You just have to go to the office, fill out a form, pay a minimal amount and you get it done. So that, a provincial ID and a credit card. So if you're buying a phone, if you're getting a phone on contract, they will not give it to you unless and until you have a credit card and you have a credit card history. They need a minimum credit score and they need to see your credit card history to know that you will be paying your monthly bills on time and you will not just take the phone and run away. So yeah, they need to make sure of that. They're not stupid people. So they will check your credit card history. So if you're someone who is new, so I remember that when I went to Canada for the first time, I had to get my SIM just the first week that I went there. And I went and I had already gotten my credit card, but I had never used it. So when I went, they asked me if I had a credit card. And I said, yes, I do have one. And when they checked my credit card, they said that I have zero credit card score because I did not use my credit card. So they said that unless and until they have at least 6 months of credit history, they will not be able to give me the phone. So I ended up using the old phone that I got from India. It was in a good condition, but I wanted to upgrade it, you know. So yeah, and okay, it is extremely expensive. Even if you get the minimum of plans, you have to pay at least $45 to $50 every month. So that, it's just unavoidable. Now let's get into the service providers. So there, this market in Canada is an oligopoly. So it has three major service providers. That is Bell, Rogers, and TELUS. Okay, and Bell, Rogers, and TELUS has sister companies. That Rogers has Fido, Bell has Virgin, and TELUS has Koodo. I personally think that if all these big companies are Rogers, Bell and TELUS, these providers give you plans that are a little more expensive than the ones that are given by the sister companies, because these companies are smaller and cater to the demands of students or people working in the in a more humble class, right? I don't know how to say it, but yeah, you get what I want to say, that they will give you plans which are more economical than the ones that you can get in Rogers, Bell or Virgin. In my personal opinion and in the experiences that I faced. So you should go for, as a student, you can go for Fido, Freedom, Virgin, Koodo, or Lucky Mobile, any of these sister companies, because they will always have offers going on. They will always have, oh my god, you have to, how can I forget this? You have to take your student ID with you, or your admission letter, or your the ID that they've given you from college. They will definitely, they will definitely have a student discount for you. I got my student discount. I think I got 20% off from the telephone services that when I went. Okay, so when you go for the fall semester, you will always have these offers going on which tell you that you will get like 10 GBs of data free, 5 GBs of data free if you keep continuing that plan for a few months. So that is there, and on top of that you'll get a student discount if you take your student ID with you. So do not forget to take your student ID when you go. It should be in the document. So yeah, documents, student ID, must. Okay, so the things to look when you are getting a plan, it depends on person to person and your usage. So it can have unlimited calling or a particular amount of calling, unlimited text, and there are three types of restrictions that are there on text. It can be worldwide, it can be Canada wide, and it can be local. So you have to make sure that you check these things before you sign the contract as to where it is. My mobile provider my service provider Freedom had unlimited text throughout the world, which somehow comes handy when you're not able to talk and when your internet isn't working. You can just text your parents or anyone back in India, whatever is happening, and it just comes in handy. Then data. So most places in Canada have data, but it is always better to have some amount of data if you go, because you might be stuck in a bus stop or somewhere. You have to check the timings, you need to check the internet is just the most important thing in our lives at this point of time. You need it for to do the basic of things. You need the internet. So I would say that you get, maybe if you don't need a lot of it, maybe get like the minimum 2-3 GB of data. And for this, the minimum plan that you will get, you'll have to pay at least $45, $50 to $60, depending on which company you go to. It differs, but it'll definitely be in this bracket of price. So yes guys, that's it for today. If you have any other questions, you can comment, and I hope this video was helpful. And yeah, please keep watching our videos. Bye.